infatuated with the Beatles at an early age. So when I was 10, I asked for an acoustic guitar for Christmas because I wanted to be Paul McCartney, and I didn't understand bass versus guitar versus probably piano at the time. And that was when I first got started. And it's pretty much been tunnel vision since then. I went to college and studied jazz, and this is what I've always wanted to do. I had a moment of freak out at the end of college where I'm like, really, I should be a doctor so I could support a family, you know? Like this momentary freak out where I signed up for all the pre-med classes and just failed immediately. And then went back to playing guitar because that was obviously the right thing for me to be doing. So.
I was into Nirvana. And actually Sean, our drummer, and I, he was in my first band. We wanted to cover Smells Like Teen Spirit at the talent show in seventh grade. And so Sean taught me the chords. I bought a little Squire guitar, and we were pretty much the coolest thing at the talent show. Guitar sort of took over everything else. And I went to college and played classical guitar in college, and yeah, the rest is history.
So the song is called Shut Up and Dance. The first thing we had was Nick came in with the chorus, the lyric and the melody. And we were just trying to find the key that he was singing and feeling it in. And so we started just doing it over the C sharp drone. This. I forgot the main riff in the song. The whole song starts with this thing. And that led us straight into this riff. And that's the verse. So we decided that having the bass and the guitar both going, a little too aggressive for Walk the Moon. And so we just had the bass do that, and we lightened up the mood a little bit by putting like a funky guitar part over it. Michael Jackson actually played a big part in this record. So that kind of lays the bed for Nick to do the verse over it. Then we get to the pre-chorus, which was kind of inspired by 70s and 80s rock bands. We kind of had the darkness in mind. Mm-hmm. So it's even though we're not a two-guitar band, it's a two-guitar arrangement. Where
it's pretty riffy.
The first one goes. Yeah, and then the second guitar just kind of basically plays higher inversions of that. The chorus took forever to figure out what the arrangement was. The best thing ended up being just power chords. Just repeat that, you know? Don't overcomplicate it. But we did. So we've got those power chords going on, and then we've also got Mr. Jackson returning. Over the power chords, and we've got a guitar going absolutely ape shit and going. So we got all three of those things going on, and finally we have a chorus arrangement that sounds big and competitive. It was a fun part to write. It's really different from a lot of other Walk the Moon stuff, so it's always a fun moment to get to do those kind of Rolling Stones kind of inversions, you know?
But there's a ton of energy. I mean, even though it's like somewhat simplified, it's there's so much energy, and we really feel it live. It kind of comes out.
Yeah.
It gives you a chance to just dig in and and dance around, and it's great.
Shut Up and Dance is a song that we wrote here in LA, actually. We were searching for something bright and upbeat and found ourselves in this zone of Jesse's Girl and Hit Me With Your Best Shot and these, you know, anthems of the mid-80s, you know? Jams, big jams. So lyrically, it sent me into this place of like, wouldn't it be great if we could write the dork rock and roll anthem, you know?
Oh, don't you dare look back, just keep your eyes on me. I said you're holding back, she said shut up and dance with me. This woman is my destiny, she said ooh, ooh, shut up and dance with me.
The tone is like quite a journey for us. We're pretty used to what we've got live, maybe little things sort of change day to day, but so nuanced that anyone who's not on the tour with us every day would never notice. But in the studio, it changes, at least, especially for Eli, it changes quite a bit, I think.
She took my arm, I don't know how it happened. We took the floor and she said, oh, don't you dare look back, just keep your eyes on me. I said, you're holding back. She said, shut up and dance with me. This woman is my destiny. She said, ooh, ooh, shut up and dance with me.
Live is kind of the time for the ego, because when you're on stage, you've got to be confident and you got to sell yourself to all these people in this room. But when you're in the studio, you really have to give yourself over to the song. If something wasn't working, we'd be like, well, pull up Hit Me With Your Best Shot and let's listen to that. And it's like, wow, this is really heavy, but the guitars are completely clean. How are they doing that?
Yeah.
You know?
We pulled up the cars, just what I needed. The sound of each individual thing, the drums, or the guitars were like pretty, almost polite in comparison to what you'd consider hard. But the heart is like, it's just all over it. So it leaves you feeling like you've just been rocked, you know?
Oh, come on, Eli.
I think a lot of stuff that we have really gotten into as a band in the last couple years is not all cool, you know? It's stuff that is fully on board with whatever weird thing it's got going on. So for us, I think with each song on the record and with Shut Up and Dance, we wanted to find the vibe and then just go all out, go balls to the wall. Or else you're just gonna end up with some half measure thing, which is like almost, that's cool. You know, so we're trying to break the ceiling of almost.